A 700 Newton window washer is standing on a uniform scaffold. Scaffold is sometimes if the buildings are so high, cleaning those the windows of this building is not so easy. So that's why they are going to use some a platform which is known as scaffold. It's a board on which the man is standing and then cleaning the window from outside. So this scaffold, this platform is called scaffold. This scaffold is supported by a vertical rope at each end. So the scaffold weighs 200 Newton and 3 meter long. So you are going to draw a 3 meter long board, scaffold. It's a board. Let's draw in here. This is 3 meters long board. It is called scaffold. So let's indicate that this length of this scaffold, which is 3 meters from one end to other end, this distance is 3 meters. Question is saying that this scaffold is uniform. This uniform, when it says uniform, you are going to say that center of gravity and center of mass is the midpoint, the geometric center. Where is the geometric center? It is midpoint in here. So this scaffold has 200 Newton weight. This is the FG force scaffold. That's why you are going to draw this weight, this gravitational force from the center of mass or a center of gravity. And I'm going to draw from this midpoint FG, FG force scaffold. So FG, how much? Which is 200 Newton. 200 Newtons. And if it is the midpoint, which means this 3 meters length must be divided into two. I am going to divide this scaffold because midpoint divides this 3 meter long scaffold into two parts. 1.5 meters in one side, other 1.1 meters on the other side. So this is the, so this gravitational force, this is the midpoint, which is center of gravity, center of mass, divides this 3 meter into two. And there are two ropes, vertical rope.
Teacher, that uniform means we will locate the FG in the middle of the scaffold.
Of course, uniform means that. Uniform means middle is the center, which is the central mass. You are going to draw the gravitational force always from central gravity. And central mass and central gravity are, remember, almost the same point always for most situations. Okay?
Okay, thank you.
And all right, then there are vertical ropes at each end. I am going to draw vertical ropes at each end. One rope is on one end. So let me draw with color. This is one rope. And other rope is on the other end. Yes, two ropes. Question says that, what is the force in each rope? Yes, because there is tension force acting by the rope on the scaffold. Let's show them. One tension is on the right end by the right rope, FT. One more tension on the left end by the left rope. One of them I am going to say FT1, other one I am going to say FT2. Two tension forces. What is the force in each rope? We will find them one by one. What is this and what is that? When the window washer stands 1 meter from one end. So you are going to locate this man, this window washer, 1 meter from one end. You can choose right end or left end, so you will get the same result. I located this man to the right, closer to the left end, sorry. According to Malzem, and I am going to solve it in here. And this man is 1 meter, this window washer is 1 meter from one end, which is from the left end, according to the question. Of course, this window washer has a gravitational force. How much? So 700 Newton. So he's going to be pushing this scaffold by its own weight, which is 700 Newton pushing down. Fg of man, 700 Newtons. There are two Fgs. One of them is the gravitational force, weight of the washer. The other one is gravitational force or weight of the scaffold. That's why I'm going to say one of them is Fg1. The other one is Fg2. So there are four forces acting on the scaffold. Tension force one, Ft1 in the first drop. Tension force two, Ft2 in the second drop. Gravitational force, weight of the man, Fg1. Weight of the scaffold, Fg2. So all the forces are already drawn because steps are like this. Remember, first, draw all forces. First step, draw all forces on the board, on the scaffold. We already did them. Second step, remember, choose axis of rotation. Choose axis of rotation. So axis of rotation, what is the logic? Choose the location of one of the unknown forces. Which forces are unknown in here? Ft1 and Ft2. You can choose any of them. You can choose Ft2. If you choose Ft2, location of Ft2 as axis of rotation, you first calculate Ft1. If you choose the location of Ft1 as axis of rotation, you will first calculate Ft2. So only order of the calculation will change. But my method is always choosing the left end. You also do this one, okay? This left end, the location of Ft1, I am choosing as axis of rotation. Axis of rotation. I already choose axis of rotation. Next, determine distances. Determine distances for each force. Distance of each force. Let's do that. Distance from force to axis of rotation. Let's start Ft1. Ft1, it's acting on axis of rotation. If a force acts on axis of rotation, what is torque of that force? Torque of tension one is zero because this force is acting on axis of rotation. What about Fg1? What is distance for Fg1? From Fg1 to axis of rotation. What is that distance? It is 1 meter. Distance is, yes, this. So let's calculate torque of Fg1. Fg1 is trying to rotate in clockwise direction or counterclockwise direction according to this point O. Clockwise rotation causes a clockwise rotation, negative. Fix your pen from axis of rotation, push in the direction of the force, and see that. It produces a clockwise rotation, so negative torque. Angle is 90 degrees because gravitational force always in vertical, so the scaffold in horizontal. These angles are 90 degrees. So we don't need to deal with the angle because sine 90 is one always. Let's calculate torque of G1. Torque of G1, it is negative because clockwise rotation is negative. How much is force? 700 Newton. How much is distance from force to axis of rotation? 1 meters. Multiply them, negative 700 Newton meters. Torque of G1 is negative 700 Newton meters. Torque of G2, G2 also produces a clockwise rotation because its torque is also negative. So torque G2 is negative. How much is your force? 200 Newton. Distance from this force to axis of rotation, how much is that distance? 1.5, already determined. 1.5 multiplied by 1.5. So torque G2 is, if you multiply them, it is negative 300 Newton meters. I calculated torque of G2 as well. And last force, torque of tension two. What is, tension two produces clockwise rotation or counterclockwise rotation? Counterclockwise rotation, so a positive torque. So then let's calculate torque of T2, so which is equal to positive. How much is the force? I don't know. I will calculate it, FT2. How much is distance from force to axis of rotation? From FT2 to axis of rotation, how much is that distance? 3 meters. It's given in the question. Length of the scaffold multiplied by 3. I already calculated tension, torque of tension 2. 4 forces there are. I calculated 4 torques. All the torques are calculated. And now I can apply rotational equilibrium. So apply rotational equilibrium. What is condition for rotational equilibrium? Sum of the torque acting on the board must be equal to 0. I will add all these torques and make them equal to 0. Yani torque of tension 1 plus torque of G1 plus torque of G2 plus torque of tension 2 is equal to 0. Torque of G1, we calculated it's 0 because it's acting on axis of rotation. Torque of G1, sorry. Torque of G1 is negative 700. Torque of G2 is negative 300. Torque of T2 is, tension 2 is positive 3 times FT2 is equal to 0. So this is negative 700, negative 300 becomes negative 1000. Negative 1000 plus 3 times FT2 is equal to 0. This is negative 300, take other side as a positive. 3 times FT2 is equal to 1000, divide by 3, divide by 3. So FT2 becomes 333.3 newtons. I calculated one of the torque, one of the force. I calculated FT2 as 333.3 newtons. How many unknown forces left now? One. If one unknown force is left, which condition of equilibrium I am going to use? Translational equilibrium, because it will help me. Now I am going to use translational equilibrium for calculating FT1. I know that sum of the force acting on this scaffold must be equal to zero. All the forces are along y-axis. That's why I am going to study only y components, because there is no x component in here. Positive y direction is will be written positive in equation. Negative y direction of the forces will be written negative in equation. So let's start from the left end. So sum of the force acting on the scaffold along y-axis must be equal to zero. FT1 is unknown, but I know that rope always pulls the scaffold upward. That's why I am going to write for FT1 positive. But FG1, in which direction? FG1, in negative y direction. If it is in negative y direction, I am going to write negative. How much is FG1? 700. 700 newton. This is FG1, 700 newton in negative y direction. FG2. This is FG2. It's also in negative y direction. How much is the force? 200 newtons. What about FT2? I already calculated F positive. How much I calculated? 333.3 is equal to zero. Let me add them all. FT1. Add them all. How much is this answer? I think this answer is 500, negative 567 minus 567 is equal to zero. If we get this negative to the right side, it becomes positive. Yani FT1 becomes positive 567 newtons. This is the force of the second rope. There are two ropes. One of them is on the right. The other one is on the left. The one on the right is 333.3. The one on the left applies a force which is equal to 567 newtons.